Hello everyone, myself Dr. M. Srijan Kumar. My education background is pharmacy. We have been dealing with a topic called as Galenicals. This topic is in continuation with the first session. In the first session, we have discussed about definition of Galenicals and different types of extraction processes. The four types of extraction processes to be discussed under these sessions. The first extraction process like infusion, second one decoction, and the third one is maceration have been completed in first session. If you want to view that first session, please go to my channel and find first session and just have a look on it. Then after understanding the first session, you can come over down to the second session, what we are dealing today. Now we will move on to the next extraction process called as percolation process, which we haven't discussed in the first session. So what do you mean by percolation? Per means through, colere means to strain. Okay, so coming to the definition, the process in which a comminuted drug is extracted of its soluble constituents by the slow passage of suitable solvent through a column of drug. So from this definition, what do we understand? Like comminuted drug is nothing but powder drug. Comminution is a process involved in reduction of particle size. Okay, so comminuted drug is nothing but powder drug of desired particle size. Okay, this particular powder drug is packed in a column. Okay, so through that column you need to allow passage of suitable solvent. On allowing this passage of suitable solvent to the column of drug packed in a equipment, so what happens, the soluble constituents will be extracted into the solvent. This is the definition about your percolation. The process of percolation includes 5 steps. The first step is combination of drug, second step imbibition of drug, third step packing, fourth step maceration, and fifth step is percolation. Coming to the first step, combination, it is the size reduction of drug, usually from coarse powder to fine powder. As I explained you before about the definition of combination, reduction of particle size of your drug. So you are converting from coarse powder to fine powder. So what is the purpose of combination here? In order to increase the surface area, the first purpose is to increase surface area. Less particle size, more will be the surface area. More surface area, more will be the absorption. When absorption is more, your bioavailability will be more. When bioavailability will be more, your therapeutic effect will be more, which we are expecting for any drug. So the first purpose is to increase surface area. What is the second purpose? To ensure complete removal of drug. What is the second purpose? To ensure complete removal of drug. What do you mean by that? So whatever drug that you have packed in the column, so you need to ensure that entire soluble constituents should be entered into the solvent, that is passed through your column. Next, to slow down the movement of menstruum. What do you mean by this, to slow down the movement of menstruum? So when you pack something like drug into the column, ultimately the movement of the menstruum will be slowed down when the particle size is less. And after this, in order to ensure uniform packing, you are going to reduce the particle size, because when you have uniform distribution of particle size, ultimately what happens, you can expect uniform packing of your drug in the column. Okay, that's all about your combination. Coming to the next step of your percolation process, the second step is imbibition. What do you mean by imbibition? Nothing but swelling of drug by absorbing menstruum. It is allowed to stand for 4 hours in a closed container. What you need to do, you need to take your drug, the drug to be added to a container. To that container, you need to add the menstruum. Menstruum is nothing but solvent used. Okay, that solvent to be added to that. And it has to be left aside for 4 hours. It is done to achieve following objectives. What is the purpose of imbibition? Okay, in order to achieve, what are the objectives to be achieved? To avoid choking, that is nothing but to avoid difficulty in movement of your solvent through your drug packed in the column. Okay, to remove air, if there is any air entrapment between the particles, can be removed through a step called as imbibition. To avoid washing out of fine particles, if there are any fine particles that are present in your drug, because there are different types of particle sizes will be present. Okay, so fine particle size, what happens, they will get easily washed out. So when you subject for imbibition, they start swelling by imbibing your menstruum, so that these fine particles will not be washed away. Okay, so that's the purposes of your imbibition. Coming to the third step, packing. We said that drug should be packed in a column. So how to pack that? After imbibition, drug is evenly packed into the percolator. So percolator is the equipment involved here in the process of percolation. So the equipment involved in the process of percolation is called as percolator. Your imbibed drug should be evenly packed in the percolator. Then what you need to do, then a filter paper is placed on the bottom to support the column of drug. So after packing that, okay, into the percolator, at the bottom of your drug, you need to place what? Filter paper. Then the moistened drug is placed on the filter paper. Okay, always what you need to do, you need to take a percolator. In that percolator, at the bottom of the percolator, you need to just place your filter paper. Okay, after placing the filter paper, what is the purpose of filter paper here? In order to support your column of your drug. Okay, and after that, the moistened drug is placed on the filter paper. Over the moistened drug, another filter paper is placed having weight on it. Okay, over the moistened drug, another filter paper should be placed. Okay, so this entire setup is nothing but a column like. Then menstruum is added. Menstruum is added onto your filter paper, top filter paper. Close the lid if menstruum is volatile. If your solvent is volatile, what you need to, ensure to close the lid of your percolator. Next step, fourth step, is maceration. Now, after packing, sufficient menstruum is added and covered with lid. When liquid begins to drop, the lower orifice is closed. Okay, what happens in maceration, you know, when the packing is done, now when you start after pouring your liquid into the percolator and after closing the lid and everything, the setup is ready. When the liquid begins to drop, start moving from your upper portion to the lower portion, it is about to drop to the orifice, you need to do what? You need to close the lower orifice of your percolator. Then percolator is set aside for 24 hours. Percolator is set aside for 24 hours. This is the fourth step. Coming to the fifth step called as percolation. Before going on to the fifth step called as percolation, first we will revise the four steps again. The first step is what? Comminution. What you are going to do in comminution? You are going to reduce the particle size and convert from coarse powder to fine powder. Okay. After comminution step, what you are going to do? You are going for imbibition step. So in this imbibition, you are going to subject your drug with the menstruum. Okay. After subjecting your drug with the menstruum, what happens? Ultimately, the drug will imbibe the water and it will start swelling. After imbibition, what is the next step that is involved here? Packing. So how you are going to pack this? First, you need to take the percolator. Okay. Percolator is the equipment used in percolation process. In that percolator, at the bottom of your percolator, you need to place one filter paper. What is the purpose of filter paper to be placed at the bottom of the percolator, inside the bottom of your percolator? Remember, not externally, you need to place inside bottom of the percolator. What is the purpose here? To hold your column of drug. Okay. So after that, you need to place your moistened drug onto the filter paper, and after placing your moistened drug, again you need to place one more filter paper on top of it, and you need to place some weight on it. Okay. And after that, you need to add the menstruum to your percolator. After adding menstruum to your percolator, first you need to judge what type of solvent is added with. Whether the solvent is volatile or non-volatile. So if the solvent is volatile, ensure to close the lid. Okay. And after that, now your entire setup is ready. That is about your packing. Coming to the maceration. So after a complete setup is done, so in maceration, when the solvent starts moving from top portion to the bottom portion, okay, then you need to do what? You need to ensure that the orifice is closed. Okay, so this is your maceration, till your maceration step. Coming to the percolation step now. So in maceration, when the orifice is closed, you need to set aside of your percolator for 24 hours. So coming to the percolation, after 24 hours, what is the next step? That is nothing but your percolation. Okay, after 24 hours, lower orifice is open. As I said, now the it is in closed condition, right? So you need to open the lower orifice, and menstruum is collected with a controlled speed until 3/4 of menstruum is collected. Now you need to collect 3/4 of menstruum. So here one indication is that you need to collect the menstruum at a controlled speed. It is not like you open the orifice tap and all of a sudden you collect the menstruum. It is not like that. You need to collect at a controlled speed. Okay, how much menstruum is to be collected here? 3/4. Done. Then more menstruum is added and collected from the lower orifice so that mark does not become dry. So after collecting 3/4, now externally more amount of menstruum should be added to the percolator. It is something called as washing your markma. Mark is nothing but the column drug is something called as markma. Okay, so it is the residue left after extracting the solvent. Okay, because what is the mechanism here, you know, just it's an imaginary mark. You have packed something called as drug, okay, in the column. Now when you pass the solvent, what happens here? Whatever the constant that are present, it will move through the solvents, and after complete movement of your all your soluble constituents, what is something that is less? It is called as residue. That residue is nothing but called as markma. Residue is nothing but called as mark. So some amount of remnants may left inside the residue, some soluble constituents. So in order to wash that, you need to do what? You need to add more amount of external menstruum to the percolator. Okay, after that again you need to collect the whatever that solvent that comes from the orifice. Now then mark is pressed to get extract which is combined with previous liquid, and at the last, okay, after washing, you need to press the mark. Mark is nothing but the drug that is columned in packed in the column, that you need to press that. So when you press that, some amount of solvent also will come, that is nothing but called as extract. Okay, so this one should be mixed with the previous liquid, and after mixing, then it is allowed to stand and then it is filtered. Okay, then it is allowed to stand and then it should be filtered. In the general process of percolation, particularly in the manufacture of concentrated preparations like liquid extracts, the following problems may arise. So if you check with the general process of percolation, particularly when you manufacture something like when you are expecting a concentrated preparations liquid extracts to be manufactured, here there are some problems that may arise during your percolation process. What are they? If the active substances are thermolabile, that are nothing but which are sensitive to heat, okay, which will easily destroy with the heat, evaporation of large volumes of dilute percolate may result in partial loss of the active constituents. So if your active substances are thermolabile, which are sensitive to heat, so on evaporation of your large volumes of your dilute percolate, what it will do? It may result in what? Partial loss of your active constituent. This is the one problem. In the case of alcohol water mixtures, if it is in the first case, it is something called as completely solvent, okay, alcohol. In the second case, mixture of your alcohol and water, evaporation results in preferential vaporization of alcohol, leaving behind an almost aqueous concentrate. Okay, if it is an alcohol water mixture, so on evaporation, what happens? Whatever alcohol that is present will get evaporated, and at last it will leave something called as an aqueous concentrate. This may not be able to retain the extracted matter in solution, and hence the substance may precipitate. You cannot ensure that that aqueous concentrate is something called as your whatever extract that you are expecting. Okay, so because the soluble constants whatever expecting, which may not retained in your extracted matter, okay, that too in a solution form, so what happens? That substance may get precipitated. In such cases, the general process of percolation is modified as described in the next. As these two problems arises, one with the solvent, complete evaporation, the other with the solvent, which is a mixture of your alcohol and water. So whatever problems that are arising in general process of percolation, now what we need to do, you need to modify the percolation process. Okay, so that is how we are going to see. So in order to modify that, there are two methods used: reserve percolation method and cover and rundown method. Reserve percolation, cover and rundown method. So what happens in reserve percolation, we'll see. In this case, extraction is done through the general percolation process. All the extraction will be done through the general percolation process, whatever we have discussed. At the end, the evaporation is done under reduced pressure. So evaporation is the critical step, right, in the percolation process. If you can see the two previous points, so we can talk something like evaporation is the critical step. So that evaporation should be done under reduced pressure in a equipment like climbing evaporator. You need to subject your entire extract to a climbing evaporator, and that evaporator will be run in a reduced pressure, okay, until you get the consistency of soft extract, that to a semi-solid, such that all the water is removed. So you will be evaporate till you get a semi-solid extract, that is nothing but called as soft extract, where your entire water will get removed out. This is then dissolved in the reserved portion, which is strongly alcoholic and easily dissolves the evaporated portion with any risk of precipitation. So what you need to do after getting that semi-solid, now this particular semi-solid extract should be dissolved in a reserved portion, okay, and that reserved portion, dissolving in a reserved portion, nothing but a solvent which is strongly alcoholic. When you do this, ultimately that particular alcohol, concentrated alcohol, will get evaporated easily in the small portion, will get evaporated easily. So after evaporation, you cannot see any sort of precipitation which we have faced earlier. Okay, that is about your reserved percolation. The next one is cover and rundown method. Cover and rundown method. This is a process that combines maceration and percolation techniques. Okay, this cover and rundown method process will run on two basic principles. One is maceration, the other one is percolation technique. This process cannot be used for materials that contain volatile principles or for those which undergo change during the evaporation stage. And this particular cover and rundown method is not applicable to the materials which contain volatile principles and next which will undergo change during the evaporation stage. If such materials are sensitive to change during evaporation stage and which contain some volatile metals, and this cover and rundown method is not applicable. This procedure is advantageous because industrial methylated spirit may be used for extraction instead of costly rectified spirit. The main advantage of this cover and rundown method is that here industrial methylated spirit is used instead of your costly rectified spirit. So it is a cost effective method. The detailed procedure is as follows. After the imbibition stage, still imbibition, everything will be common. The material is packed in a percolator and macerated for few hours with a suitable diluted industrial methylated spirit. It's a common one. Then the liquid is run off and the bed is covered with more menstruum. Maceration is done as before and the second volume of extract is collected. Okay, what you need to do in the next step, you need to run the liquid to the bed. Okay, and that particular bed is covered with a menstruum, that is nothing but your solvent. Okay, and maceration is done as before, the same thing whatever you have done, and the second volume of extract is collected. Okay, because two volumes of extract will be collected. The first one is the 3/4 volume, and the second one is you will be running some more menstruum to that, and the third one is extract after pressing the mark. This process is repeated several times, with the latter weaker extract used for extraction of fresh batch of drug. Okay, this procedure again and again it has to get repeated. Okay, so whatever weaker extracts will be there, that also will get with this particular solvent. More concentrated fractions are evaporated under reduced pressure to eliminate the toxic methanol. So what you need to do the next step? So more concentrated fractions will be there, whatever extract you have got, that should be evaporated under reduced pressure to eliminate what is the main necessary to evaporate under reduced pressure? To eliminate toxic methanol. After the concentrate is assayed for the active principle or for total solids content, it is diluted with water and ethanol to obtain the correct concentration of alcohol and active principle. After that, what you need to do, whatever concentrate that has been obtained, okay, that should be assayed for your active principles as well as your solid content. After getting your desired content, Okay, what you need to do, this particular concentrate should be diluted with your water and ethanol, okay, to obtain the correct concentration, desired, correct means desired concentration, what you are expecting for, that will contain what your alcohol and active principles. This is the procedure about your rundown method. Yeah, coming to the next apparatus for your percolation process, it is called as succinate apparatus. On laboratory scale, in order to perform your percolation process, you can use this succinate apparatus. So coming to the parts of your succinate apparatus, it consists of a flask, a succinate extractor and a reflex condenser. The raw material is usually placed in a thimble made up of filter paper and inserted into the wide central tube of the extractor. Okay, so thimble is nothing but a plug-like substance. Okay, now your raw material is usually placed in the thimble, and that thimble is made up of what? A filter paper. Okay, and this thimble should be inserted into the wide central of the extractor. Alternatively, the drug after imbibition with menstruum may be packed in the extractor, taking care that the bottom outlet for the extract is not blocked. So what is the next step that you are going to do? Now the drug which has been previously imbibed with the menstruum, okay, it should be packed in the extractor, taking care that, okay, the bottom outlet of the extract is not blocked. Now the solvent is placed inside in the flask and brought to its melting point. Its vapors pass through the larger right hand tube into the upper part of the extractor and then to the condenser, where they condense and drop back onto the drug. Okay, what happens when you subject this flask to a boiling point? Now the you need to take solvent, that solvent to be placed into your flask, as I told, the part of your succinate apparatus, and this particular flask containing your solvent should be brought to a boiling point. So what is the mechanism involved? You know, after boiling, the solvent gets boiled. Now the vapors start moving through the larger right hand tube of you into the upper part of your extractor. Okay, now from the flask, these particular vapors will move to the extractor, move through the extractor, and then from the extractor it will move through to the condenser, where they get condensed and drop back onto the drug. After condensation of your vapors, they will fall onto your drug. During this period, the soluble constituents are extracted. When the level of the extract reaches the top of the siphon tube, the entire volume of extract siphons over into the flask. Okay, so slowly, slowly, the drug will start, the soluble constituents will start extracted. Okay, when the level that reaches to your siphon tube, the entire volume of extract siphons over into the flask. This process is continued until the drug is completely extracted. The extract in the flask is then processed. This process is thus a series of short macerations. So after completion of this extraction process, now you need to subject your extract for series of maceration process, where you are going to get your final product. So let us see the image of the succinate apparatus, then you will understand. So can you see the image of your succinate apparatus? We'll see with the second. First, we will understand the parts of the succinate apparatus. Can you see the condenser? As I said, extraction chamber, thimble where your drug will be packed. This is your siphon arm, and below you can see flask. Okay, so the first part will be from the bottom will come. First part will be the flask. This particular flask containing your extraction solvent should brought to the boiling point. After brought to the boiling point, vapor will move through the, as I said, right hand tube. Through that, it will go to through, it will pass through the extractor, where your extractor will contain what? Your thimble containing your drug. Okay, this is your extraction chamber. From that, they will, it will go, it will pass through the condenser. There your vapors will get condensed and it will pass your drug. So, and these particular things will be indicated into your siphon arm. This is the mechanism here. Can, if you can come to the first image, can you see there is an H2 inlet and the H2 outlet. To this succinate apparatus, you need to connect to the running water tap. One is inlet and the one is outlet. Can you see here? Bottom, you can see solvent that is present in the flask. Okay. And can you see the direction solvent passed through the thimble wall that is packed in the extractor? Okay. And solid material being extracted. Can you see? Vapors will pass through this thimble and it will go to the condenser, where it vapors will get condensed. Official extractor, coming to the next apparatus, official extractor, An official extractor, as described in the official monograph, IPBP, is illustrated here. In this case, the extraction is a continuous percolation process. So for any material, if you are expecting some extraction, is a continuous percolation procedure. In this apparatus, vapor rises through the extraction chamber, passing the drug container. The vapor condenses in the reflex condenser and returns through the drug, taking the soluble constituents to the flask. Can you see the setup? Below, you are going to subject your flask for heating and solvent for your extraction. That is nothing but your menstruum and drug packed in a thimble, okay, in an extraction chamber, and you will be having a reflex condenser. This is your official extractor that is published in your official monographs. Coming to the next apparatus, the original percolator, okay, and this is how your percolator will look like, okay, for small scale. Small volume percolators will be available, and for large scale, large volume percolators will be available. So what are the parts of this particular percolator? We will see. You are having something called as percolator metal plate and sacking or straw layer, okay, and at the bottom you can see connectors for removing percolate or for spurging steam, in order to supply steam or in order to remove your percolate, okay. At the bottom you will be having some valves. And can you see the drug that is packed here? Okay. And you are having some port for discharging the drug and running in the menstruum at the top. Okay. Yeah. How it works? The drug is supported on a perforated metal plate covered with a layer of sacking or straw. So at the bottom, can you see a perforated metal plate will be there? On that, a covering of layer will be there called a sacking or straw. Onto that, your drug is packed now. The percolator has a removable lid, which contains port holes for running the solvent in and for absorbing the flow of solvent. So at the top portion, you will be, this vertical percolator consists of a removable lid. Through that removable lid, there are some ports, there are some inlets provided. Okay, one inlet is for your running the solvent and for absorbing the flow of solvent. The outlet from the percolator is fitted with a tap and pipeline. This outlet permits removal of the percolate for subsequent processing or for use as a menstruum in a second percolator in series, resulting in more efficient use of menstruum by carrying out the extraction in a countercurrent manner. So at the bottom, can you see there are connectors for removing your percolator? Okay, this is nothing but this particular percolate at the bottom is fitted with a tap or pipeline. Okay, through this pipeline, you are going to collect the percolate or you are going to run the menstruum to the other percolator, which is in continuous. Sometimes for some materials you will be moving on to continuous process. In that cases, in order to use your menstruum efficiently, you can connect this pipeline to the other, okay, continuation. Okay, on the small scale, copper percolators were originally used, but they are now largely replaced with percolators made up of glass or stainless steel. So if you check with the small scale percolation process, same kind of setup will be there, but the make of the percolator is from copper. But when you go to the large scale percolators, so they will be making with the help of your stainless steel or glass. A slightly conical percolator is better than a cylindrical one, since the sloping sides permit the eventual expansion of the bed. So always the percolator shape plays an important role here, okay. So conical percolator will be better than a cylindrical percolators. The advantage of conical percolators is that this particular sloping slides, okay, will result in expansion of the bed. Can you see conical? So it will be narrow at the bottom, but when you move to the upper, it will just expand itself. So this is how your drug bed will be expanded and allows the solvent to permeate the material present near the sides at the bottom. Not only expansion of the bed, but also it also allows the solvent to permeate the material present near the sides at the bottom, which is a problem with a cylindrical percolator. So this particular solvent not only moves to the center, but it also moves to the sides of your percolator. This particular step makes an advantage for your advantage for your conical percolator, but it will not result in your cylindrical percolator. Cylindrical percolator, it's a disadvantage. That's all about the setup about your large scale percolator. Yeah, that's all about your percolation process. That's how we complete the different extraction processes. So coming to the next topic, methods of preparation of tinctures. Methods of preparation of tinctures. Generally, tinctures are prepared by the following processes. There are two processes are involved for the preparation of tinctures: maceration and percolation, which we know better by listening to the previous session and slides. The example for your preparation of tincture is orange tincture. The first example taken into consideration is orange tincture. RX is fresh orange peel, 7.5 grams. Alcohol 90%, 30 ml. So what is the theory for your orange tincture? So fresh orange peel is the fresh outer part of the pericarp of the ripe or nearly ripe fruit of Citrus uranium. It belongs to the family called as Rutaceae. Now we are talking about the botanical name of your orange, like Citrus uranium, and it belongs to the family called as Rutaceae. Okay, so what we need to take for this particular preparation of orange tincture, we need to have fresh orange peel. Okay, so what is this fresh orange peel? It is the outer part of the pericarp, okay, of the ripe or nearly ripe fruit, anything you can take. So this fresh orange peel is used for the extraction because it contains more volatile oils than dry. Why we are going for fresh orange peel? Because fresh orange peels will contain more volatile when compared to your dry peel. The inner white portion of the peel is excluded because it gives bitter taste to the preparation. So after taking your fresh orange peel, so inside, if you can see, okay, you can find some white peel. Okay, a white portion will be present inside. Okay, 3D like portion will be present inside. That should be completely peeled off. It should be excluded while subjecting your orange peel for extraction process. Why? What is the reason? You know, this particular white portion will give bitter taste to the preparation. The peel is thinly sliced to expose the oil glands and embedded therein and to expose more surface area to the action of solvent. And after just removing that white portion, now you need to cut your orange peel into small slices. Okay, very thin slices, so that all your oil glands that are present in your orange peel are exposed outside. Okay, because always the oil glands will be embedded inside, so you need to expose them outside, so that when you cut it into small pieces, there is one more advantage that the surface area will get increased. Generally, alcohol in a concentration of 70% or more is required to solubilize the volatile oils. But since fresh orange peel contains a large portion of water, if dilute alcohol, and therefore 90% of alcohol is used, which is diluted to 73 to 78%. So generally, any extraction process where volatile oils are involved for extraction, so normally we use a percentage of alcohol about 70%. But here, why we are taking 90%? The reason is that this orange peel, as we are saying, that it is collected from fresh oranges. When you say fresh oranges, it will be having more water content inside. This water content will dilute 70% to less percentage. So when we take 90%, ultimately, if water is present in the orange peel also, that particular water will just alter your concentration to 73 to 78. That is better for your extraction process. This is the reason. During maceration processes, occasional stirring is necessary to displace the saturated layers of menstruum around the drug. If percolation process is well and good, but if you go for adopting maceration process, occasional stirring is necessary. Why it is necessary? In order to displace your saturated layers of your menstruum around your drug. This leads to more effective extraction. When you just when you shake occasionally, what happens? It will give more effective extraction. Filtration is necessary to remove insoluble cell contents which are introduced due to pressing of mark. As I said, that after the extraction process is completed, when you ensure that entire solvent has been passed through your drug packed in a column, so at last you need to press the mark. Mark is nothing but the residue obtained after complete elution of your soluble constituents. So here also the same step should be done. Okay, after pressing the mark, you need to just go for filtration. Because on why filtration is necessary, you know, because when you press the mark, ultimately there is a possibility that some insoluble cell contents will be passed through your solvent. Adjustment of final volume is not done to keep uniformity of the strength of the finished product. So at the end of the extraction process, you are not allowed to adjust the volume because it will alter your strength of your finished product. Coming to the procedure involved in the preparation of your orange tincture. First step, take fresh orange peel and cut it into the thin slices. Weigh the required quantity of thin slices and macerate it with whole quantity of alcohol in a covered vessel. So what you need to do? You need to take fresh orange peel, cut it into thin slices. After that, weigh required quantity of your thin slices and you need to go for maceration process by subjecting your weight quantity of your thin slices with whole quantity of alcohol in a covered vessel. Because alcohol will get evaporated. We know that. Yeah, coming to the second step, you need to allow it to macerate for 7 days with occasional stirring. After the strain the liquid, press the mark and mix the expressed liquid to the strained liquid. Clarify the combined liquids by filtration. So what is the second step here? You need to, after completion of the maceration, after subjecting your thin slices to maceration, you need to keep aside this particular setup for 7 days. After 7 days, in these 7 days, you need to go for occasional stirring. Why occasional stirring? Here the maceration step is involved. After 7 days, you need to strain the liquid. After straining the liquid, you need to press the mark and mix the expressed liquid to the strained liquid. Okay, what you need to do? After pressing the mark, whatever liquid that is obtained is an expressed liquid. And directly whatever you got, the straining liquid is called a strained liquid. You need to mix this both and you need to clarify the combined liquids by filtration. Both should be filtered. Okay, and should be mixed. Next, dispensing. Transfer to an amber colored glass bottle, light resistant container, and close tightly to avoid the loss of alcohol or volatile principle by evaporation and decomposition of the volatile constituents with loss of flavor by light. Okay, dispensing, it should be dispensed into an amber colored glass container, because we know that the two ingredients are there. One is volatile ingredient, the other one is the ingredient that evaporates when it is exposed to external environment. As these two ingredients are present, so you need to enclose in a amber colored glass container and it should be tightly sealed. So okay, when you don't tightly seal, ultimately whatever volatile principle that is present, it will get evaporated and it will affect your flavor, okay, when it is exposed to the light. Direction, to be used as directed. Storage, it should be stored in well closed light resistant container and in cool place to prevent the volatilization and determination of active constituents. So the storage, it should be stored in cool and dry place. At the same time, it should be protected from the light to prevent volatilization. Okay. Uses, orange tincture is used as what? Flavoring agent. The use of orange tincture is flavoring agent. Next, method of preparation of spirits. Spirits can be prepared by any of the following methods. Okay. The spirits can be prepared by any of the following methods. The first method, simple solution method. Next, solution with maceration. Chemical reaction method and distillation method. The four methods for the preparation of your spirits. So the spirit that we are going to discuss today is peppermint spirit. The RX is peppermint oil 6 ml and your alcohol 90% 60 ml. Coming to the theory, peppermint oil is obtained by distillation from the fresh flowering tops of Mentha piperata. So here in the RX we have mentioned peppermint oil. So we need to know how the peppermint oil is obtained, the source of peppermint oil. This peppermint oil is obtained by a process called as distillation. Okay, from where? From the fresh flowering tops of Mentha piperata. It's a botanical name of your peppermint. It is a colorless or pale yellow liquid. Coming to the properties of your peppermint oil, colorless or pale yellow liquid, having a strong penetrating odor of peppermint and pungent taste. It has a penetrating odor of peppermint and it has a pungent taste, followed by a sensation of cold when air is drawn into the mouth. Followed by, it will give a sensation of cold when air is drawn into the mouth. That's the properties of the peppermint. The odor of fresh peppermint is due to the presence of 2% of volatile oil, most of which is lost due to drying off. So, and the odor that is responsible for your peppermint oil is of 2% of your volatile oil that is present. Okay. And most of which is lost due to drying off. When it gets dried off, whatever odor that is present, it will get lost. Peppermint spirit, BPC, is prepared by solution method in which peppermint oil is dissolved in alcohol. The method involved here is simple solution method. Okay. But official peppermint spirit USP is prepared by solution with maceration process. When you check with your BPC, it is prepared by a simple solution method. But when you check with the USP, it is prepared by a simple solution in combination with maceration process. Okay. Now coming to the procedure. Dissolve peppermint oil in a small amount of alcohol. If the solution is not clear, shake it with purified talc 5% and set aside for some time and then filter it to get the clear liquid. So what you need to do, the first step, you need to take peppermint oil. That peppermint oil should be dissolved in small amount of alcohol. If you feel that the solution is not clear, shake it with purified 5% of talc should be added in order to make clear solution. And you need to set aside for some time and then filter to get the clear liquid. And add the remaining amount of your ethanol to make up the final volume. This is the procedure. Coming to the dispensing. Here also transfer to amber collector glass container, and it should be, because of the volatile contents of your volatile oil that is present as a constituent, and apart from alcohol is present, it will result in evaporation. So, and it also loses its flavor. So in order to do all this kind of stuff, you need to dispense in an amber colored glass container. Storage: peppermint oil and alcohol are volatile nature, therefore the preparation is stored in a cool place, 20 degrees centigrade, and they should be protected from flame or fire, as it contains volatile and alcohol and oil, and it should be stored in a cool place. At the same time, it should be protected from flame or fire. Coming to the auxiliary label, keep away from direct flame or fire. That is very important for any kind of dosage form which contains high amounts of alcohol. Uses: peppermint spirit is used as flavoring agent and carminative in flatulence and nausea. It is used as antiseptic and local anesthetic. So what are the uses of peppermint oil? As we know that, as usual, it is used as a what? Flavoring agent. And apart from flavoring agent, it is also used as a antiseptic. Okay. And apart from antiseptic, it can be used also as a local anesthetic. Okay. And it is also used as a carminative. So what do you mean by carminative? Carminative is nothing but expelling the gas, is nothing but called as carminative. Okay, expelling the gas from the gastric is called as carminative. It is also used as a flavoring agent in pharmaceutical preparations and in certain candies, chewing gums, etc. Okay, not only as a carminative agent, it is also used as a flavoring agent in many pharmaceutical preparations, okay, and in certain candies, chewing gums, etc. Coming to the method of preparation of extracts, there are three types of extracts which are classified based upon their nature. The first one, liquid extracts, semi-solid extracts, and dry extracts. Coming to the method of preparation of your liquid extracts. Liquid extracts are liquid preparations of which, in general, one part by mass or volume is equivalent to one part of mass of the dried herbal drug or animal matter. What would be the expected composition of your liquid extract? You know, it consists of one part by mass or volume, okay, of your liquid is equivalent to your one part by mass of the dried herbal drug or any animal matter. These preparations are adjusted if necessary so that they satisfy the requirements for contents of solvent and where applicable for constituents. And these preparations, not only one part by mass of your liquid, one part by mass of your herbal drug, okay, this can be adjusted based upon the requirements for the contents of the solvent inside your formulation, or based upon the constituents that should be incorporated to your formulation. So coming to the production, liquid extracts are prepared by using ethanol of suitable concentration or water to extract the herbal drug or animal matter, or by dissolving a soft or dry extract which has been extracted by direct extraction of the herbal drug or animal matter in either ethanol of suitable concentration or water. So these particular liquid extracts are prepared by using two things: either ethanol of suitable concentration you can use, or you can also use water. Okay, it is not like you can also go for direct dissolving your soft or dry extract into your water or any concentration of your ethanol. Liquid extracts, after completion of dissolving this your herbal drug in required concentration of your ethanol or water, you need to just filter your extracts. Slight sediment may form on standing, which is acceptable as long as the composition of the liquid extract is not changed significantly. So you may expect some kind of sediment at the bottom of your formulation. Okay, that is okay, that is acceptable actually. When the properties or composition of your liquid is not changed significantly, till that point it is acceptable. Okay, what is acceptable here? Your sediment that is formed at the bottom of your extract. Next, storage. It should be protected from light and labeling. On the label, it states in addition to the requirements content of your ethanol in final extract. So on the labeling, you need to mention what is the strength of your ethanol that is used. That is very important. That's all about your today's session. And in this today's session, we have been discussed about percolation process. We have been discussed about your method of preparation of tinctures, method of preparation of your spirits, method of preparation of your extracts. That's all about your today's session. Thank you. This completes your Galenicals topic. Thank you very much. Please view, like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.